individual. In that case, any director of lending company should not be done, loan should not be given, or of a company which is its holding company. That means what we could able to perceive or conceive. Suppose A, B will take, for example, A is a holding company, B is a subsidiary company. How it appears by reading this language, the holding when a director is a common director in both A and B, it looks, I'll give furthermore example, the A company has got 6 directors and B company has got 10 directors. And B company is a holding company. When the subsidiary company gives loan to the holding company, the whole language appears prohibit to give loan to the 10 directors, all the 10 directors. Irrespective of anything, as long as the director is also a director, it not only qualifies the director alone, it also qualifies the entire board. But in case of loan from holding company to subsidiary company, it only disqualifies the director, common director. It is not disqualifying any other director. That means, as long as loan is given from holding company to subsidiary company, as long as other than the common directors are there in the subsidiary company, that the left out directors can be given loan by the holding company. And that director can deal with the money, whatever they want to deal. With our understanding, we can see that this is the only way out how the loan can go from holding company to subsidiary company.
Good point.
In fact, good point, but the purpose.
Directly or indirectly.
Yeah, that everything and the sky will come in that. But it's a very valid point, but one thing we have to see that here the purpose why the company is giving. That is one purpose, one thing we have to see. The next thing, what I read out is it restricts firm, it restricts private company, it restricts body corporate. So body corporate definition is an inclusive definition. It's inclusive definition. It excludes only the corporation sole, which is not in vogue right now, cooperative societies. So except other, everything can be brought under body corporate. But for that matter, trust will come under body corporate? No only. Trust cannot come under the body corporate. Then still can I give loan? See, probably I can say yes only. In a limited sense, as long as trust and company is not having any common transaction. By the way, company or trust is getting benefited out of it in unfair way. It is tricky situation, but it can be interpreted that way also and can be interpreted this way also. For? HUF. HUF is not at all a format, sir. Sir can explain more about it. He is expert on that. Both are expert on that. I heard.
You must have heard about Margadarshi Financial Services, if you say about HUF. When the NBFCs are prohibited to carry on the financial activities, what they have prohibited is a company, partnership firms, individuals. So they have forgotten the HUF. So one intelligent person started. So a former Chief Justice of India gave the opinion HUF can carry on the finance activity. So Margadarshi Financials in Andhra Pradesh borrowed 3,600 crores. So for 20 years it carried on. Then ultimately one MP raised the voice. How can you borrow when prohibition from public deposits? By way of public deposit, 3,600 crores they borrowed in the name of HUF. And then this HUF promoted limited companies, 3-4 limited companies, this money is given to those limited companies. Then it has gone to parliament, then it has gone to assembly. So much furor, so many high court cases, politically of course, the motive is politically. Then ultimately AP High Court said, it may be a drafting error, and we asked the RBI. RBI said, now we are withdrawing, now you please give you 1 year time, repay. So then the company repaid 3,600 crores. So the HUF in civil law is not a legal entity. In civil law, only HUF for income tax sake, because as CA students who study HUF, HUF, we think HUF is also a body, or HUF is also a legal entity. There is no legal entity in the civil law. In the name of HUF, you cannot file a suit. That is the legal position. HUF is also a person. There is the matter, I think you can file.
Basically, HUF emerged out of the Hindu law for the purpose of property division. But over a period of time, it got evolved into some other thing. Now it has gone to a stage of doing business also. The whole concept can be, I can rather say, little getting misused only.
Can you come again, sir, with a question?
I just wanted to know, the Companies Act 2013, on the related party transactions, is there any change, especially,
yes.
Yeah, that's what I just wanted you to enlighten.
Yes, under the Companies Act of 1956, under 297 related party transactions, companies which had paid up capital of 1 crore, they had to go for central government approval, if prior central government approval, if they had to enter into any related party transaction. Now that central government approval has been done away with and a special resolution is sufficient. Yes. Sir, so that would be the last question.
See, on this question on borrowing, in case of borrowing, you are saying that resolution needs to be passed subsequently at the time of renewal, but in case of borrowing, the borrowing will be continuing the books. You will be continue to borrow the money from the bank, even though there is no specific agreement. Will the situation change?
No, the contract which I referred, the term which I referred, even if it carries renewal also, it is invalid.
No, I am not talking about renewal. See, there is already a borrowing, 5 crores or whatever amount. It will be continuing in the books. I would have already borrowed. My books will show an amount of 4 crores or whatever. It will be a running account which will be in the books. So, still I have to go for 180 approval from the shareholders, or I have to wait till the renewal to get the shareholders approval?
That means the company has already borrowed before this provision of section 180 one becomes effect. Now, still the loan amount, that borrowed amount is reflected in the company accounts. Your concern is whether it is violation of the provision.
Correct.
That's what I was responding. Any money borrowed before introduction of the section can be borrowed only by virtue of a contract. Whether money goes out or whether money comes in, anything can happen only through a contract, some term. As long as that term of period through which borrowing is made is complied, that means the company has borrowed in September 11th. Will take purposefully, the company has borrowed and signed and got credited also on September 11 with the term that it will be repaid only after 3 years, only within 3 years, not after 3 years, then and in, there's no end. Within 3 years, then the that particular portion of money alone can be reflected up to 3 years.
I think it's 188.
If I have a transaction under 188, I should not make any credit sales. I should make it on only cash basis, because loan section will apply in the book as it becomes my book debt.
Right. The loan includes book debt.
So all my 297 transactions should be on cash basis only. And if I have already made credit sales and I have a book debt before 12th September, and I don't enter into a contract, If I make a sales, it's like they'll repay in 90 days, normal course of time. And I don't have a written contract. It has not been mentioned in invoice or anywhere else. What is the situation in that case?
You are making the sales to another person in 90 days, you are saying.
Yeah.
Same 90 days you apply to a related party also.
But so it depends, right? For a few party we give 90 days credit, few parties we give 120 days credit. And what you will take?
No,
you
are extending the question. But anyhow, see, genuineness,
no,
the
for
intent
all party we are not giving the same credit.
The spirit of the act, please prohibit the related party transactions. That's what, to interested persons, directly or indirectly, in the name of sales, in the name of some other thing, don't give the money. That's what the intention of the act. But in reality, if you want to comply the law, you say, for others I have given 120 days, for these people also 120 days, after 120 days I collected the money, no violation. But for these people, if you give 180 days, 270 days, further I am extending, definitely you are a violation, subject to question. So that's how, better to square up and comply the law.
Interested question only, the loan given to director prior to 12-9-2013 with a stipulation that the loan is repayable on demand. What will be the position when the repayment is not demanded by the company for so many years? Why? Father, mother, you can give letter, you please don't pay. Why? It's hide and seek game. The intention of the law also will be seen. Intention of the law should be seen. It talks about some share option. Can you explain? It takes time to understand.
The holding company declares the employee share option plan, and in this process the employees of subsidiary company are also eligible for this plan. And one of the director of the subsidiary company also applies for the shares, and the company gives option of recovering the amount in 12 installments. So I have, at this point in time I am declaring this or recording this amount as advance in my books, whether this attracts section 185, if so, what is the way out?
185. No, no, you are recording as?
As advance in my books.
Advance?
Yes.
Advance to?
To the director.
To buy the
because I am going to recover in 12 installments.
Company cannot lend money already in the existing
company. If you already recorded before September 12.
No, after that.
After it cannot be done.
So, but I am also, this option is given to all employees of the company, not only the director.
Okay, but it includes director, no? The problem, that only the problem. Other than the director, anyway, employee is not going to fall under 185. The director alone, squarely they will fall within the position of 185.
So,
what will be the intention?
So what is the way out, sir, actually? In this
way out. You remove that person from the board. Appoint him as a manager.
Or any special resolution will help?
Pardon, sir?
Any special resolutions?
Special?
Special resolutions.
Why are you for this?
Act violation by pass resolution, I want to amend the act.
One resolution, every company will pass 100 page also. I will violate entire act. It's not possible.
Okay, thank you.
Repayment term of a loan has not been stipulated. Now, what would be the position? Then, one of my friends asked. Here, our institution.